Welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages, and our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I'm Reena Sharma and today's headlines are: In India, former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram will head the Congress Manifesto panel for the 2019 polls, and election strategist Prashant Kishore has joined the JDU. In Punjab, radical Sikh preachers have been accused of being Congress puppets, and a pro-Khalistan militant group has claimed responsibility for a blast. In Canada, the federal government's legal bills are rising sharply, and Saskatchewan Premier Scott Moe will not support the government's ban on handguns. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: The Congress has begun preparing for the 2019 Lok Sabha polls with party chief Rahul Gandhi. Former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram has been tasked with steering the party's manifesto with his appointment as chairman of the Congress Manifesto Committee. He will be aided by Rajya Sabha MP Rajiv Gowda as convener. Election strategist Prashant Kishore has joined the JDU in the presence of Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar. Kishore had formulated Prime Minister Narendra Modi's election strategy in the 2014 elections. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu has invoked India's first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru in his address to the Serbian Parliament. Naidu said that relations between India and Serbia were deeply rooted in history. A joint India-US military exercise has begun at Chobatia in the foothills of the Himalayas in Uttarakhand's Almora district. This is the 14th edition of the joint military exercise, which is hosted alternately by the two countries. The Jammu and Kashmir Election Commission has announced a 9-phase panchayat elections in the state beginning November 17th. Elections will end on December 11th. The United Front of Left Students Group AISA, SFI, AISF, DSF has won all four central panel posts in JNU-SU polls. The voter turnout in the keenly contested election was 67.8%, believed to be the highest in 6 years. The same group of right-wing activists is behind the killings of rationalist Narendra Dabholkar, M.M. Kalburgi and journalist Gauri Lankesh, a senior police official has said. They were reportedly assassinated by members of this gang because they were raising their voice against the Hindu religion. 15 patients suffering due to faulty hip implants of Johnson & Johnson have approached the Central Expert Committee. Days earlier, it was found by the Union Health Ministry to determine the quantum of compensation to be provided to them. Simranjeet Kaur, Monica and Bhagyavati Kachari claimed gold medals as Indian boxers notched up an impressive 7 podium finishes at Turkey. Simranjeet, a former national medalist, defeated Turkey's Sema Kalaskan to fetch the top honours. Singer Kailash Kher has wished CBFC chief and lyricist Prasoon Joshi on his 47th birthday and called him the best human being he met in the world of art. Kher also shared several images of himself with Joshi on his Twitter page. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as news from Punjab and Canada follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: SAD President Sukhbir Singh Badal has accused radical Sikh preachers Baljeet Singh Daduwal and Dhyan Singh Mand of being Congress puppets. The statement has once again raked up an issue that rocked Punjab's monsoon session. Pro-Khalistan militant group Bhindranwale Tigers Force of Khalistan has claimed responsibility behind a low-intensity blast at a Jalandhar police station. A purported letter mentioning this went viral on social media. Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has stated that he is committed to ensure peace in the state and will continue to take all necessary steps to maintain law and order. Singh has also charged the SAD with attempting to vitiate a peaceful atmosphere. A police team has arrested a man in connection with the Rewari gang rape case. However, the prime suspect is still absconding. Meanwhile, Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar has ordered transfer of Rewari SP and posted IPS officer Rahul Sharma in his place. Rebel Aam Aadmi Party MLA Sukhpal Singh Khera has alleged that Chief Minister Amrinder Singh wants to save those indicted by the Justice Ranjit Singh Commission report. Khera claimed that by giving time to accused police officers booked in Behbal Kalan firing case, the government had given them a chance to get a stay from the High Court. Former Deputy Speaker Bir Devinder Singh has demanded removal of Advocate General Atul Nanda for failing to defend the state in two important cases. Beer claimed that in both the sacrilege and Faridkot rally cases, the AG has embarrassed the government. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that the forthcoming 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev will be celebrated across the world. He also lauded the role of Gurdwaras towards cleanliness in society. A Delhi special court has dismissed the plea of former Director General of Police S.S. Saini, seeking to recall Justice Rajiv Bhalla of Punjab and Haryana High Court as a witness. Saini witnessed Bhalla as the witness for further cross-examination in a 24-year-old kidnapping case. Cash-strapped Punjab government is facing fear of another liability of over 9,000 crore rupees per annum. This came after the Punjab and Haryana High Court quashed the recruitment policy of the state, giving a fixed pay to probationers. 20 years after a precious memorabilia was reported missing, the Patiala police have registered an FIR pertaining to theft. The memorabilia was donated by legendary hockey Olympian Balbir Singh Senior to Sports Authority of India run Netaji Subhash National Institute of Sport. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Canada follows. Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com, and the top 10 headlines from Canada are: the federal government's legal bills are rising sharply, driven in part by fresh trade disputes with the US. The Department of Justice has paid $26.4 million to outside law firms and other legal agents in 2017-18. The fee is the largest amount paid since the government began publicly reporting figures 5 years ago. The Ottawa government is forging ahead with its plan to study a complete ban on handguns, but don't expect Saskatchewan Premier Scott Moe to line up behind the government's latest gun control initiative. Saskatchewan has the highest crime rate in the country. NDP leader Jagmeet Singh is calling on Prime Minister Justin Trudeau to quickly call by-elections. This is for the handful of ridings where there are current or soon-to-be vacancies, including the constituency he plans to run in. Premier Doug Ford's government is making changes that will weaken the opposition's ability to slow down passing of controversial bills. The decision came as the Ontario legislature ended sitting without passing controversial legislation on the size of the Toronto City Council. Canadians are saddened by the fallout of Typhoon Mangkhut's destructive winds and heavy rain, which set off landslides, destroyed homes and left at least 12 people dead. Canadians are praying that the destructive Typhoon Mangkhut should pass soon. New data reveals that Canadian Armed Forces are struggling to get more women, Indigenous people and visible minorities into uniform. In an attempt to boost their numbers, the Department of National Defence is set to launch a suite of new digital tools. Aircrafts are searching for the British Columbia interior plane with two people on board that's gone missing. Joint Rescue Coordination Centre has said that its Pacific Division is notified that a small private plane was overdue on a flight from Edmonton to Chilliwack. The Ottawa government has committed to restore rail service to the town of Churchill, which will include at least $117 million from the federal government. The funding consists of $74 million to help repair damaged rail line and buy it, along with the town's support from Denver-based Omnitrax. Canadian cannabis entrepreneurs and investors can face a lifetime ban from the US over their involvement in the industry. A senior US border official has said that Canadians in the burgeoning sector could be deemed inadmissible to the US. Rare remains of an Ice Age wolf pup and a caribou has been found by scientists in northern Canada. They claim that the mummified remains will offer insights about life in Canada's far north more than 50,000 years ago. Rare remains of an Ice Age wolf pup and a caribou has been found by scientists in northern Canada. They claim that the mummified remains will offer insights about life in Canada's far north more than 50,000 years ago. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources. From accounting firms to wedding planners in your city, all of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Content is a king for Ayushman Khurrana, and his choice of movies are a proof. His journey from Vicky Donner to the last released Bareilly Ki Barfi is epic. In his next Andhadhun, he is playing a blind pianist helmed by Sriram Raghavan, the trailer of which released last week that received applause from celebrities and Twitterati alike. And now, the first song too saw its release. Titled Naina Da Kya Kasoor, the film's male lead Ayushman shared the song video on Twitter and wrote, "When you can see without seeing, you are in love." Naina Da Kya Kasoor, song out now. The song shows a blooming love between Ayushman and Radhika and how by the end of the song, she suspects that he is not really blind. Well, besides Andhadhun, Ayushman has also signed another quirky film titled Badhai Ho, a laughter riot in which Ayushman's mother gets pregnant at an older age. Ayushman's all films have been very pleasing to the eye. Let's wait to see more of him this year. Filmmaker Rajkumar Hirani says he is not actor Sanjay Dutt's close friend. Hirani told screenwriter Anjum Rajawali at the Indian Film and TV Directors Association's special masterclass in Mumbai. Hirani said, "The film Sanju has nothing to do with my relationship with Sanjay Dutt. I could have made some other films, maybe PK Part 2 or another part of Three Idiots, but I got carried away by hearing this story. I don't think I am his best friend. I made the film because of his story. Though I have done two films with him, like Lage Raho Munna Bhai and Munna Bhai MBBS, I have never partied with him. I do not come under his friend circle. He is close with Sanjay Gupta, Mahesh Manjrekar and those people." What was his perception of Sanjay? "My perception of Sanjay was that, though most of his actions are wrong, like sleeping with his friend's girlfriend, keeping the gun, doing drugs, etc., but he is not a villain. He is not a bad man from his heart." From Sanjay's drug addiction, personal affair, a jail term, to his bonds with his parents and friends, Hirani's Sanju delved into different aspects of the actor's life, but many felt that the film also left out a lot. A few days back, actor Shahid Kapoor was spotted outside a recording studio in Mumbai, looking all exhausted, trying to balance his personal and professional life. From being there for Meera as she delivered Zen, to taking care of Misha, who was not keeping well since a few days, and to being there for promotions of his upcoming film, Patigul Meter Chalu, Shahid had a lot going on in his head. Well, this frustration came out with the paparazzi. He got a little irritated with the shutter sound of the camera. While conversing with the actor, see here what happened.
Well, the film is called Patigul Meter Chalu. So, jaisa title hai, waisi film hai. Title quirky hai, entertaining hai. Film ke andar ek message hai. To ye dono cheezein is title ke andar inka mishran hai. Film bhi aisi hai. सर नहीं हो पाएगा प्लीज़ आप लोग फोटो टक टक टू प्लीज़ 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 सॉरी आई स्टार्ट अगेन
वेल गुड न्यूज़ इज शाहिद हैज रिज्यूम्ड मूवी प्रमोशंस एंड विल बी सीन इन द अपकमिंग फिल्म पतिकुल मीटर चालू ही हैड अर्लियर स्टेटेड हाउ बीइंग अ पेरेंट वाज अबव ऑल द मूवी विल रिलीज ऑन द 21st सितंबर Recently released, Abhishek Bachchan, Vicky Kaushal and Tapsee Pannu star Aman Marzia is receiving praises not just from the critics and stars but also from Twitterati users. But unfortunately, Tapsee is not being a part of these praises and the reason is her name. After watching the movie, filmmaker Karan Johar tweeted, "Vicky Kaushal is all gusto and glory portraying a manic lover with genius abandon. He has some moments of brilliance in the film. Tapsee Pannu holds the strings of her layered character like an absolute veteran. Bravo, Manmarzia." Well, Tapsee found out Karan had not tagged her current account in one of the tweets. Here's what Tapsee said. "Karan, you need to start tagging me correctly now. I always end up missing these compliments on my timeline. I worked hard for it." Karan apologized and said, "Oh no, I am sorry." Well, this didn't stop there. Arjun Kapoor also wished the Manmarzia team on Twitter. Here's what his tweet reads. "In a time where the world needs more love, let's hope the audiences give Manmarzia the highest form of love. All the best." Tapsee replied to Arjun, "Thank you, Arjun. Now tag me right after you see the film, please." Arjun said, "I'll hug you after I see the film, tagging that so last season." Then Karan asked Arjun, "You must tag her, right? If and when you do. She gets very upset otherwise." To which the actress replied saying, "Yeah guys, I want to make sure the compliments and wishes are delivered at the right address." So what do you think? Isn't it their conversation funny? The biggest public festival Ganesh Chaturthi commenced on Thursday. Many Bollywood celebrities welcomed the elephant-headed god home. Actress Shilpa Shetty Kundra, who brought home the idol on the 12th night, now took part in the Visarjan ceremony. But her Visarjan ceremony was unlike any other celebrity. Why? Because she danced and celebrated each moment of the occasion. Watch it yourself. Well, this was not it. She finally played the dhol with the bandwalas. Well, truly the lady knows how to enjoy every moment of her life. Won't you agree when I say that this was unlike any other Ganpati Visarjan you've seen?